All right, guys, GoToBoy32 here. Check it out. So I'm getting ready to do this video for you. But before we do this, I just wanted to do a little prequel. We're not fear-mongering in this video. What we're doing is we're telling the truth. Right now, our Second Amendment is it's being attacked by all sides. And unfortunately, there's enough people out there who, they refer to these individuals as FUDs with their idea that you don't need an everyday sporting rifle to exercise your Second Amendment right for protection. Well, there's going to come a day when they're going to come for your high-performance military-style sniper rifle, a.k.a. deer rifle. So just let this be known, this is only a start. When you have an administration who is hell-bent on banning certain firearms, creating a, registration list, and incorporating things called a mandatory buyback. Guys, even some of the most far-left individuals have deemed this thing as unconstitutional, but there are individuals out there, and I'm going to talk about it in the upcoming video. They do not care about your Second Amendment right. They do not care about your ability to protect your home or family, and yet these are the same individuals who encourage defunding the police. That's probably going to piss a lot of people off. But in any case, let's talk about this. The new appointee that Joe Biden just made, and just how dangerous this individual is to your rights and my rights and our Constitution. Here we go. Y'all have fun. All right, guys, GoToBoy32 here. Check it out. So we're sitting here in the Freedom Office having a cup of coffee. And first of all, before we get started, I want to give a big shout out to my good friend Papa Les, who made me aware of this story last night on a really cool chat that we were doing. Also, as kind of a promotional thing, I want to give a big shout out to the Real Cobra Burnout. Real Cobra Burnout got a hold of a company. See this thing right here? This is kind of a display mount that is in the shape of something that you put your other thing on top of. Then if I say something about it in this video, YouTube will probably take it down. But this is made by a company called Rad Labs. 3D.com, and I'm going to put the link down below so you guys can go visit. But this is pretty cool little deal, man. Thanks, Real Cobra Burnout. I really appreciate that. All right, so what are we talking about? We are talking about the appointment to Biden's so-called presidential team, a lady named Jen O'Malley. Now, this was made available. Jen O'Malley Dillon will join President-elect Joe Biden's incoming administration as Deputy Chief of Staff. Now, this is pretty big. That's a huge appointment because she's going to be in charge of the day-to-day operations of what that senile fool is going to be working on. What's he going to be working on? Well, let's just go back to the good old days of Beto O'Rourke. Now, Jen O'Malley, at the time when Beto was still active in the campaign, she was his campaign manager. And Jen O'Malley, later after that, became the Joe Biden's campaign manager. Now, that's an interesting thing about the whole election. I've got a personal video I want to do on that whole subject because I've got my own personal beliefs on basically how the Republicans were outplayed. And they were outplayed from the very beginning. And these guys have got to join the party and start playing with equal reciprocation if we ever plan on taking the White House back. All right, so anyway, let's talk about this. Jen O'Malley. Who is she? Well, let's take this. I'm going to give you a good little brief insight on who Jen O'Malley is right now. Here we go.
An assault weapon ban is very, very important, and we need to have it. But that only takes weapons of war off the streets in the future. It does nothing for weapons of war that are currently out there. And I think there's 15 or 16 million. A peace plan for a safer America by March for Our Lives. There is a section in here.
All right, so let's talk about this real quickly. March for Our Lives. Remember the kids that got together after the thing down there in Florida? This was a deal that was backed by Bloomsburg, Moms and Man Actions Now, every town, and they put together this big, huge organization called March for Our Lives. It was just one more way to enable them to exploit these children for their cause. Remember, don't ever let an emergency go to waste, right? So this is a list of details that these individuals, March for Our Lives, want, which includes annihilation of the Second Amendment, rearranging the courts, doing a bunch of other things, redefining the Second Amendment as it relates to militias as a government-run organization and not the individual's right, Heller versus D.C. So anyway, let's continue.
In here that asks for a federal ban on assault weapons and high-capacity magazines, as well as a national gun buyback and disposal program.
Right. So what happens is, and this is the way they're going to do this. They're going to introduce this thing. And thank God, as of right now, while I was doing this video, the Republicans still hold the Senate. Just be reminded that if you're watching this video and you are in Georgia and you're leaning towards that Reverend guy, you should listen to what that gentleman said. He's a madman. Okay. So with that being said, we have to retain ownership of the Senate. Otherwise, it becomes a tied effort. And you know who the president of the Senate is? It would be Harris. And Harris would be the deciding factor on anything that became locked like this. Now, as it relates to the Second Amendment, I don't think we're going to have anything to worry about because there are so many Democrat congressmen and senators out there who their constituents are very pro-2A, and it would surely mean the death of their tenure in the Senate. But in any case, this is where I'm going. So many people out there have basically said, oh, we don't have anything to worry about. They're not going to say Obama was in office for 8 years and didn't take your guns. Well, Obama didn't have a stance immediately and campaigned on it that, bingo, this should be illegal. Then he wants to make sure that if you have one, you register them. So now they know where they are. So when it comes time for the mandatory buyback, if you don't sell it back, then you have to register it. And then after you register it, they know who you are. Guys, this is just a recipe for disaster as it relates to us, the freedom-loving people with the Second Amendment. I'm talking to you guys. So all the gentlemen out there who believe that, well, the Second Amendment, you don't need an assault rifle to defend yourself. What's going to happen, ladies and gentlemen, is there's going to be something that happens where your beautiful deer rifle, aka the high-powered sniper rifle, a military weapon of war, is going to be put on the list. And the next thing you know, you're going to register that so that the next time something is used, well, they're going to come after it. Look what happened in New Zealand. Look what happened in Australia. And for those individuals that say their murder rates are so much lower than ours, no, they're not. No, they're not. And by per capita, we have one, we're 28th in the world with firearms used in the act of a crime. And a couple of things that I'd mentioned to talk about the most dangerous items that are on their list. One is the red flags. Guys, this is one unconstitutional way to take one's firearms away. But the other one is the repeal of the Protection of Lawful Commerce in Arms Act. I always have to look that one up. But basically, that's, well, their way of being able to put firearm companies out of business by allowing individuals to sue that firearm industry or gun dealer, also gun dealers, if their firearms that they sold to someone ends up in the hands of a criminal. The whole thing strikes me. It's just being ludicrous. And it's just them reaching their anti-Second Amendment. They are anti-gun, and they are justifying everything they can in order to take your firearms away from you. My AR-15 is not a weapon of war, ladies and gentlemen. It looks a lot like it, but it is not. The functions are completely different. Not many people know that, but these idiots out there, they don't care about facts. All they care about is this crap that's being spewed down their throat by Bloomberg, Mom's the Man Action Now, and Every Town for whatever it is. So with that being said, guys, this is where we're heading. If this eventually comes to fruition and Joe Biden does become president, well, guys, this Jen O'Malley is going to play a major role in taking away our firearms. Because they can justify it. It's no big deal to them. There's no skin off their back because, one, they probably don't even own a firearm. Absolutely disgusting. All right, guys, we always leave them like this. I'm really upset. I'm not happy at all about this whole situation. Because as day to day comes closer to January, Donald Trump, you need to fight as hard as you can. We need to fight as hard as we can. The Democrats had it planned out all along. Mail-in ballots was the greatest way for them to take over because all they had to do was get grandma, grandpa, anybody out there in a nursing home, the homeless guy on the street. All they had to do is get a ballot. And hey, what's your name? Hey, guess who you're voting for today? But they played the game and they played it well. But we need to be in the same position to be prepared to take it back by any means necessary. And I'm not preaching war. But I am talking about we need to be prepared. God bless America. God bless those men and women in uniform 24/7 for our freedom. With freedom is not freedom. I'm talking about the men and women in uniform who will uphold our Constitution as it was written by our founding fathers. If you liked the video, please share it, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe if you haven't already done so. This is an emotional time for all gun owners, and I'll be perfectly honest with you. I'm not ready to give up my firearms for no amount of cash. No way. And I hope you are of the same mindset. It's KB32. I'm out.